Hello my fellow gearheads, today I'm here with a quick look at the alternate builds that I managed to create from this LEGO Technic race plane 4-1-17 so far. The number has reached 33, which is my new personal record. The previous one was 31 that I managed to build from the LEGO Technic A271, which was a small wheel loader set. I couldn't post any photo of these models altogether because the first 20 of them were exhibited at the LEGO house here in Billund for a year, and they were closed in a glass cabinet together at the Masterpiece Gallery with other mocks from my LEGO colleagues, not only from design. And finally, the time has come to reveal what is coming as well next, because the first 24, I believe, were already shared, and I can show you as well very quickly what is right now already done. The first model that I created from this set is this Kingfisher. You can open and close or flap the wings simultaneously. You can raise the head and you can rotate it to the side. And you can as well slightly change the angle of the legs. And it comes with a free fish over here. Number two was this whale. And as soon as you move it around, it flaps the tail up and down. And you can as well open and close the mouth. Number three is this jet plane, which doesn't have any proper functions except for the landing gear that you can just roll it on. But I like the design with the forward swept wings. Number four is this flamingo that can rotate, and as soon as you do so, it raises and lowers the head. You can as well pose the other leg however you want, and it comes with a base so it stands on its own. Number five is this huge baby dragon, and again synchronized flip moving function that can be activated by this lever in the middle. You can as well angle the sections, the outer sections of the wings. The same goes for the tail, that can be slightly angled up and down, and you can as well angle the position on the feet and small ear flaps on the head. Number six is the Stegosaurus, and it has synchronized movement of the head and tail, so it swings the tail from side to side to protect itself against its enemies. I like as well the back crest built from the system parts, and you can as well pose the hind and the front legs however you please. Number seven is this A-Wing from Star Wars. It features a retractable landing gear that is synchronized, so as soon as you push one of the legs, it automatically closes or opens. I really do like the overall shaping of this ship, which resembles the classic Star Wars A-Wing. Chameleon is number eight. You can move the head up and down just by pushing on the tail. You can as well swing it from side to side. The tail is angled, or you can angle the tail all the way, and you can as well pose all the legs of the chameleon. Do you like what you see so far? And if you would like to build any of these alternate builds, just check out the link down in the video description, or just use the QR code that appears throughout the video, which links you directly to my replicable page. Number nine is this Cobra, which is still the longest of the alternate builds, and I still really do like the function, which is basically just attacking. So as soon as you move the tail, the Cobra attacks. You can slightly angle the head up and down, you can open and close the lower jaw, and you can as well angle the tail sections however you please. This cool helicopter marks the 10th alternate build, and as you can see, it has synchronized movement of the both rotors. Other than that, it just has moving front landing gear, so it's easier to roll it on the table. This catamaran marks number 11. It has this counter steering rudder and sail function, so as soon as you rotate the sail, the rudder goes in the opposite direction as you would do on a regular sailboat, and it comes as well with this tiny speedboat sub-build. Number 12 is this kangaroo, which can move the head up and down just by pushing on the tail. you can rotate the head, and if you want to feed it on the grass, you just move the front paws and yeah, you can lean the head all the way down to the ground. My lucky number is number 13, and therefore number 13 is this Lucky Charm cat, and you can just by moving either the arm or the tail, rotate the head at the same time as you can see over here. This pigeon is an alternate build number 14, and you can move the synchronized wings that can flap. You can as well change the angle. You can change the angle on the tail and rotate the head like so. This walrus with a pup and a fish was created as number 15 from my alternate builds, and this model contains the most different submodels, which is the mother walrus that can move the tail and raise the head with the tusks up and down. You can rotate the tail from side to side. You can as well rotate the fins over here. The pup can angle just the head up and down, and the fish just doesn't do anything, but I think it looks pretty cool. The dog giving paw is my 16th alternate model. I really do like the head sculpt on this one, and even though it looks a bit sad, it's still very fun to play. So just by pushing and pulling on the tail, it rotates the head and gives paw. If you want it just to sit, you can simply just angle the front paw like so, and it just looks like a sitting dog. Number 17 is this Scorpio, and to be honest, it's probably the most complex function that I managed to create in any of the alternate builds so far. Just by moving the pincers or the stinger at the back, the other sections go together with it in a synchronized manner. You can slightly change the angle on the pincers, and you can as well change the angle on all of the six legs that I managed to build. I know it's missing a pair of legs, but I simply ran out of space and the elements. Number 18 is this hydroplane racer, very sleek looking speedboat, and as soon as you move it on the ground, it just rotates the propeller at the back of the engine. Number 19, and one of the tallest ones, is this guy with RC plane, which is again one of my favorite hobbies. As soon as you can rotate the head, it just is ready to get the plane launched. You can tilt the head, you can simply just remove the small RC plane and the remote from the hands of the humanoid. This cute frog is number 20. Its function doesn't use any gear wheels. It basically opens and closes the mouth just by pushing on the gear wheel at the back of the frog. And you can as well extend the hind legs so you can pretend like it's jumping or swimming. Number 21 was a wish of my colleague Carl Merriam, who asked me to do a butterfly, and I managed to build a flower as well from the leftover parts and the base that holds the whole thing. So the idea behind this is that you have synchronized movement of the wing sections, and you have a linkage at the bottom that activates the wing flapping. Unfortunately, right now the pins in there already lost some of its friction, so you can see that it can't hold the full weight of the model, but it's not that difficult just to block it in any position just using some pin connectors. Number 21 is this mosquito plane that has synchronized movement of both the propellers. Otherwise, it doesn't do much except for rolling very well on the landing gear and being very swooshable. Number 23 is this praying mantis, which, as you know, doesn't do anything else except for the limbs being poseable and looking very cute. But other than that, it just stands and looks nice. This parrot is number 24. And you can move the head and the wings together against the movement of the tail. You can as well rotate the head from side to side, and it comes with a perch to be displayed on. I'm gonna show you building instructions for this one pretty soon, I promise. And again, if you would like to build any of the previous models, all 23 were already released, have video instructions in my YouTube channel, so feel free to check it. Other than that as well, you can just check the link down in the video description to my replicable page, where you get the links for each of these models. This reindeer is my 25th alternate build that I've shown you just before Christmas last year, and you can rotate the head from side to side just by turning the tail, and there's a linkage afterwards that is directly connected to the gear wheel mechanism. Other than that, you can pause the hind legs, but that's pretty much it. The alternate build number 26 is the Star Wars Imperial Shuttle, which has the synchronized fold-up wing function. The stand is not part of the set, so you need to build something from other pieces. And without revealing too much about the function, so I do not spoil all the surprises, here is number 27, which is a sea turtle. Number 28 is a Naboo starfighter from Star Wars with a climbing ladder for the pilot. Number 29 is this Kennard plane. Number 30 is this rhinoceros family. Pelican became number 31. Horizon Zero Dawn Thunderjaw is number 32. And lastly, number 33 is this clapping monkey. So these are the models that you can still look forward to, and they're gonna be coming in the following weeks. Hopefully by the end of the year, all 33 will be published. Let me know down in the comments section which one of the new ones are you most looking forward to, and hit the thumbs up if you liked watching the video. Feel free to leave a comment, and if you are new over here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. That way you do not miss out on any of my future content. And if you are interested in building any of the previous ones, down in the video description you can find my link to my Rebricable page. And you can as well just scan the QR code that will be several times displayed throughout the video. Until next time, everybody, stay safe, take care, bye-bye, and have a lot of fun with the 4-1-17 race plane.